Welcome, you Aquarians. This is the month of September 2016, and I want to say thank you for being here. September is a month of water, the energy vibration. It's going to be emotion, a lot of emotions, a lot of changes. The zodiac element is the earth energy. You will begin with the earth energy, and then you'll change at the end of the month to the air energy. September is the month of the moon, so that is a lot of emotion, water. The moon has the illusion effect. The color is going to be white, and it's going to be the truth, the innocent, purity. You're going to be enlightened, and the divine wisdom is going to come through you. It's like the illusion is all going to clear up. It's the cloud removing away. The cosmic energy of September 2016, it's going to be Saturn and the moon. So, you know, for you Aquarius people, you are an air sign, and this month is governed by the water, and the overall energy is fire. So it's a lot of change. It's a lot of upset. It's a lot of emotional stuff. So brace yourself, because there's 5 weeks in this month. This month, it's like the guards are changing. The number nine energy is here, and the number nine and number influence the spiritual vision and enlightenment and divine wisdom. So hold on, people, because this is going to be a rough and bumpy ride for all you air signs out there in September. As we look at the first week, we have the energy of fire energy, and the first week we have the energy of strength. The strength energy is here, and it is saying have inner strength, find that inner strength, encourage patience and compassion, and understand what is going on around you. The overall energy in that first week, it is the Hierophant. And I'm working with the Sibylles, and the Sibylles message for the first week for you Aquarians, it's going to be good. The energies that come out with the Sibylle, it's going to be good, because you're going to get, it's like the universe is going to bless you with something, okay? So as we look at the second week, it's going to be a time when whatever injustice, the second week is the energy of the moon. The moon is a water energy. And whenever the water energy comes up with the moon for you guys, this is a serious energy, because what's happening for you Aquarius is that emotional upsets are going to come out. And whenever I said emotional upsets is going to come out, the moon is going to remove the illusion from you. It's going to show you what exactly is going on. It's going to let you see that you need to understand that there are things going on behind this, underneath the surface, that you're not seeing. And the energy, the overall energy for the second week, it is justice. Justice is the hair element, and it is your sister sign, the justice, okay? So expect that you will have upset in the third week. The Sibylle ear is showing that there is a lot of dishonesty, jealousy, and there are people that is working against you in the second week. There is jealousy and upset. There are people just carrying a lower energy for you in the second week. So be careful. As we look at the third week, we have the energy, your own energy. The third week of September, it's going to be the best week for you Aquarians out there, because your own energy vibration is the energy of the third week, accompanied with the Lovers, which is another sister sign who is supporting you. And the third week, it's wonderful because whatever happened in the second week, you need to make a choice and a decision in the third week. So there is going to be a time that come in the third week when you need to make a decision. And what's going to happen is that the lovers, it have to do with either a relationship in your life, or most people are going back to school and you have to make a decision whether I'm going to take this courses, whether I'm going to take that. Did I get enough study financing? For the other people who are out there, there is going to be a situation with a loved one in your life that you need to make a choice if you're going to stay in that energy vibration or if you're going to step out of that energy vibration. As we look at the fourth week as the energy vibration of judgment and the Wheel of Fortune. Okay. Wow. This month of September is powerful because when judgment comes up and the Wheel of Karma together, if you are an Aquarius that was always helping people, giving out good karmas, then expect the fourth week to be a wonderful week of the exchange of currency, of good vibrations coming in. If not, it's going to be a week whenever people are just going to come to you and they're just going to say exactly what they mean. I mean, there are going to be people coming in your life, which is just unbelievable. But with the Wheel of Karma, with the Wheel of Fortune. But what is happening here is that it's going to give you optimism for the future. Okay, so in the fourth week, expect it. This month of September is just a month of ups and down roller coaster for you Aquarians out there. It is a month where you have to stand strong in your shoes or else you just fall off balance. Okay. As we look at the fifth week, it's a much healthier breeding. It's the end of a cycle and the Wheel of Fortune comes back. So this month of September, it's like the universe for you Aquarians have thrown in everything to remove you out of whatever low energy negativity that you have been working with, to remove yourself and clear yourself out of this sort of energy that is in this month of September, because it is moving you away from that which no longer serve you, Aquarians. It is a powerful week, September, powerful month. September is going to change your life for a long time. Okay. The Sibyl is given, you will be, invited to functions because an end of a cycle is coming in, and whatever you were going through, if it was bad or good, the Wheel of Fortune is supporting you in this week to bring balance. I love this. I haven't seen this in a long time, the world and the Wheel of Fortune together, but this is just an energy, and the spielers are saying that you will be getting invitation, and if you're looking for work, if you're trying to set up a new business, whatever you're doing, you will be invited out, and there will be support, and like people are around you, and it's a month where your life, it's a life changing month for all the Aquarians out there. I want to say to all the Aquarians out there, everything in life has its ups and downs, but we're all here. This is a month where you're clearing a lot of karmas, okay? Because we're coming to the end of the year, and it's like the universe used September. September has 5 months, so it gives you like enough time in that month with all of these energies to remove all of these stuff that are going on around you, and you need to accept the changes that is coming in your life, because this is going to be a month of water and fire, and you are an air sign, so you're stuck in the middle. And it's water and fire against the hair, it's not going to happen. Hold on for the general readings, and I'm wishing you a wonderful month. The Hulkamane energies for this month of September 2016, as I have said before, it is a cosmic cleansing month. And the energies is the number 18 energies from the Orbs card. And the Angel of Love with Archangel Jovial bringing in wisdom, also with the fairies and the angels. This is so wonderful. This is absolutely wonderful, because the fairies, if you call upon the fairies when you're walking out in the forest or in the bushes or so, they will clean your energies. And if you ask them to bless you with wishes, they will also do it also. This is just so wonderful for you guys. I barely should have bring out the fairies' energies. And the angels are here, angels of love with Archangel Jovial, it's just a fantastic time, because Archangel Jovial work with your crown chakra, and this is wonderful. The next energy that I will bring out is also the crown chakra. We need to work on our crown chakra. I will leave a card here up, because we need to work on our chakras. It is very important to balance all of our 12 chakras. So always call upon your angels and guides to touch, open, and activate all your 12 chakras. The next energy I have here is from John Paul. I just love these cards. They are acceptance. I am learning to accept the things that I cannot change. I am asking everyone out there, learn to accept the things that you can't change. Again, I am learning to accept the things that I can't change. Sometimes we fight against things and we want things our ways and this and that. Sometimes we need to understand that the universe has a plan for each and every one of us. And you will say, really? Because what happened to these people and that people? Yes, the universe all have a plan for each and every one of us. And when we try one thing and we try the other thing and it doesn't work out for us, leave it. Accept that it's not for you and move on. Because if you don't do that, you just sit in the energy vibration of being stuck with one thing because you want to have that thing, and the universe is saying to you, that is not for you. It's the same way. That's why I'm doing these energies, so that people can understand these energies. Okay, the next card I have for you, this is just so wonderful, is from the Angel of Atlantis. It's one of my favorite colors card. And I have here Archangel Aniel, because this month is the moon month, and Archangel Aniel is the angel that works with the moon energy. She brings out the moon energy. She's the moon goddesses. And it says integrity, because this month is the energy of the cosmic cleansing. She is here to help us, and she has the scale here, and this is a beautiful card. Just generate and look at it. The energies here, what she is saying, you can always say Ra Mati Mara, and you keep on saying that, and it cleanses you. That's Ra Mati Mara. Say this 3 times whenever we're in the mood of being upset and all of that. Just say that, okay? And call up an Archangel Aniel. I have here 2 energies from the Ascension. And the first energy I have, it's the number 9 energy, the cosmic heart, because this month is a cosmic energy cleaning month. And it says,
I am the cosmic heart, okay? The next energy, you know, use this energy. I am the cosmic heart. Constantly saying that. I am the cosmic heart, and it will help you. It will awaken your ninth, fifth dimension frequency, and then you connect with Venus, and then the love vibration will vibrate with you. I'm kind of hurrying here. I have the next energy is Orion. Now, we have different star system, different Milky Ways. The Orion, they work with the cosmic wisdom. So you can say, I honor the masters of Orion and visit them in my sleep. This is very wonderful. I am wishing you a wonderful month, and I'm saying namaste until next month.